Hey, what's up, everybody? Laz is back once again in one of his impromptu lives. She's got to get out there and let you guys know what's going on. All right, I'm going to get a little bit of time for people to start joining. I know I caught you earlier than normal. All right, you're probably working. Try to multicast. If you can't join the live, that's fine. You'll be able to see this video later. So I have some announcements. First and foremost, the biggest announcement of all is that, and I'm gonna break this down to you, all right? So there's no confusion, there's no mistakes about it, okay? On GlobeEd, there it is on the ticker, GlobeEd.net, GlobeEd.net, okay? All my self-paced courses, are 95% off all the way up to Black Friday. There's a coupon code that you must use to get this percent off, okay? It's called Black Friday 95. All caps, one word, Black Friday 95. Let me explain to you what a self-paced course is, okay? What's up, Ahmed? All right, a self-paced course is one that you purchase, that you download, or you can watch it online and you go through it yourself. I am not there. Those are live online. That is not included. The live online coaching, okay, the live online courses that I do for weeks or months at a time are not included in this, okay? Neither is the alpha prep questions. That's not included in this. These, it's only the self-paced courses like the CCNP, CCNA course, the Network Plus course, things like that. Okay, self-paced courses. I hope I got that cleared up. All right. So just so you know, 95% off. Remember, all right, people are still voting, but it looks like that this Friday, the 20th, the live online classroom, right, that you guys vote on my Networking Doctors Instagram, ACLs looks like it's going to win. It's ahead. We've counted the votes. Okay, ACLs have it right now, so it looks like we're going to be doing ACLs. So we're going to get, you know, it's going to be 1 hour, but it's going to be speedy, but I'm going to try and give you as much as I can on ACLs. I have the lab ready, everything to go. It'll be desktop just like this. So like we did it last time, so we'll be doing ACLs. Numbered, name, standard, extended, okay, all that good stuff. We're not going to get into backles and freckles and crackles and jackals or none of that stuff, okay? It's going to be pure ACLs, all right? Now, another thing is, you know you guys have the only IP book you should have if you don't have it, the only IP book you will ever need, right? That's my IPv4, IPv6 book. I also have a course, self-paced course, that follows that book, the only IPv4 course you'll ever need, right? But it has both IPv4 and IPv6. So I decided to do a live online, okay? December 1st, all right? 6 to 9, 3 hours. Live online course for IPv4 only, okay? Just IPv4, everything dealing with IPv4. Classes, private addressing, subnetting, obviously, summarization, and VLSM. Let's see if we can get all that jam-packed in there. So if you haven't gotten it yet, all right, if you haven't gotten the book yet, or you have it, but you're busy, you can't read it, you haven't been able to get that course, 3 hours just on IPv4, okay? If you take this course, I guarantee you that if you join and you do your due diligence, right? You gotta go to GlobeEd.net though, guys. You gotta subscribe to GlobeEd.net so you can get all these updates, okay? You will leave there knowing, but it's gotta be a two-way communication. I said it before and I'll say it again and I'll continue saying it. I do not like quiet live online courses. I like people to ask me questions. Imagine that, an instructor that likes people to ask questions. All right, so this is what I want so I can get rid of any fear, any doubt, any confusion that you may have. And well, hi, Laz, how you doing? I got your book. It's amazing. I'm glad you like it, MOS. I think it's MOS or Mo 5. I don't know. I can't really tell. But thank you. I'm glad you're enjoying it. Okay. Hope you're learning from it. All right. But again, you know, reach out if anything has any issues. And we got this thing coming up on December 1st. All right. To drill things on. Also, we have a Network Plus live online. Okay. That's on January. That's in the new year. Okay. January 5th to February 18th, Tuesday, Wednesdays, 6 to 9, my time, Eastern time, Mickey Mouse time, all right? Mickey Mouse land, all right? Time, all right? So it's going to be Network Plus, all right? And then still this year, I have the CCNA Volume 2. I'm looking for your book. It's on Amazon. It's on Amazon. You just put IP so many. It should come up. It's a green book. All right, it should come up there. All right, I'll put it up on the thing here real quick. When I finish saying the announcements, I'll put it up. I'll go on Amazon myself. Because if you do purchase the book on Amazon, I'll send you, email me the receipt at info, and I'll put my email again down here for those of you that may not still have it, info at the networking doctors, my last type, doctors.com. Just email me the receipt that you bought that you got the book, and I'll send you the PDF. I'll send you the PDF so you got both. Okay. So CCNA Volume 2, December 12th to March 28th. Okay, it's gonna be a weekend class. It's gonna be a weekend class, 6 to 9 at night, 6 to 9 p.m. my time. All right. Those are pretty much it. The biggest one is just that all the self-paced courses. It's 95% off all the way to Black Friday. So that's good. But again, you guys got to go to GlobeEd. Okay? I mean, I'm sharing it here. Let me go ahead and put it up here. Okay? It's right here. Just go to GlobeEd.net. Just sign up for it. It's free. It's right here. Here's the only IPV course you'll ever need. It's right there. There's Jolie's class right here. All right? There's my new CCNA right here. There's the Network Live Online Coaching. I have a new CCNP coming out as well. Next year, January 4th. I mean, so I have a lot of classes. You just got to scroll down through all this and take a look at all the different prices. There's Ansible for network engineers. So you have all these things that are right there, okay, that are there for you, all right? So you just got to look through globeed.net, okay, and just it's free, and you get all these updates right away, okay? But let me go for that gentleman. Who was it? Ahmed on Amazon. I'm going to go on Amazon for you real quick. Amazon.com. Let's put IPv4 subnet. Let's put IPv4, IPv6 subnet. Let's see who pops up. Let's see who's the man. Oh, there I am right there. There I am right there. It's this book right here. There it is. That's all you got to type. IPv4, IPv6 subnet. And I show up. That's me in the background. All right. That's the book. That's it. Just get it. Show me that you purchased it. I'll send you the PDF for free. No biggie. Okay. Now, let's get into the nitty-gritty. Now that I said those announcements, okay? Now that I said those announcements, let's get into the nitty-gritty. I'm from Lebanon. I hope to watch the course from the beginning. Perfect. 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 That's good. Okay? Beautiful. That's what you need to do, all right? I've been getting emails. I've been getting texts. I've been getting all sorts of things, okay? And I keep this one word keeps coming up. Is this real world labbing? Are we doing real world this? Are we doing real world that? I am so tired of that word real world that you have no freaking idea how tired I am of that word. Okay. I've told you guys this a million times. All right. Everything you do, okay, everything you do, whether you do it on the packet trace, whether you do it on GNS3, whether you do it on EVNG, whether you do it in CML2, God help you with that. CML2, okay? Whether you do it on Boson, on NetSim, whatever simulator you do it, okay? Even if you're using real-world equipment, actual physical devices, okay? Even if you're using that, it's still real-world. The only real-world experience you don't have are the user experience, okay? Are the user experience where they're making the mistakes and you got to fix it. Or you got somebody in your IT department that put their finger where they weren't supposed to and you got to fix it. or that a backhoe went through a cable and then you got to call everybody and their mother and you got to wait to fix it. Okay. That's the only real world thing you don't have. So when people tell you, well, you don't have any real world experience. Well, let me ask you this there, buddy. Okay. Which real world are you talking about? I know people that have been in IT for hundreds of years that all they do is change hard drives or image computers or create usernames. You know, they just create user groups or groups or people, users on an Active Directory. Okay. What, or they just do cloud or they just do security. Okay. And they forgot everything there is to know about networking. Okay. Because they're just used to clicking, right? Because that's what they want. That they're trying to dumb you down. All right. They're trying to dumb you down. But don't worry. You don't need to learn how to configure or understand anything. You just need to know how to click the Cisco DNA, the dashboard. Just learn to work the dashboard and you'll be okay. Okay. So this real world. Now, I don't believe the hype of people telling you, I'm going to give you 20 certifications in 6 months and you are going to be in a management or mid-level position in IT. That's horse crap. Okay. The Cisco 200-301. Yes. That is the new CCNA, Joseph. My old CCNAs, even the CCNA 200-125 will show you probably 80% of that. Okay. The 200-301, it's just new terminology, new ways on how to configure things, like configuring IPv6 protocols under the interface or IPv4 protocols under the interface, calling ports ephemeral ports, or calling a rogue HTTP server spurious, or they decided to throw in Puppet, Chef, okay, and REST APIs and all that stuff, but there's just a little bit of stuff. And I said it a million times before. If you are going to do this and you're going to take a certain, not if you are, when, there is no if about it. If you're here, if you watch my videos, if you're in my boot camps, if you take my courses, if you're doing my stuff, you are going to get certified. Okay. There is no choice in the matter. You have to get it done. All right. We are already in November 17th. I had to look at the date. I don't even know what the date was. All right. November 17th. I do not care that Thanksgiving is coming up. I wish everybody a happy Thanksgiving. I wish everybody a wonderful Christmas, Hanukkah, Happy New Year's, congratulations, whatever. All right. But that's fine and dandy. Kiss the family, eat the turkey, eat the whatever it is that you celebrate. Okay. And then go study. Go study, because the new year is upon us. Time waits for no one. Get it done. Get your certs. Do I tell you? Okay, first of all, when I say go get your certs, for those of you that have never been in the IT field, for those of you that have never touched any equipment or have really zero knowledge, like when I started, I had zero knowledge. I started from the Network Plus and worked my way up. I got my A+, I got my Network Plus, I started doing Microsoft, and then around I got Cisco, okay? I did that. So I had a good foundation in networking, okay, before I got my CCNA. So if you're new to it and you want to go into networking, Network Plus is a great place to start, okay? Network Plus is a great place to start. And then you go to your CCNA, all right? And then for CCNA, you go to CCNP, but let me warn you right now. All right, because if this book that we have right now for the CCNP sticks for the next 3 years, God help us all. Good evening there, Burrows. All right, hello. Anthony, you're back. What's up? All right. God help us all, okay? This past weekend, we were doing zone-based firewalls. That was mind-blowing. Good inspiration on my lunch break. No problem, brother. I'm glad I could help out. Rodrigo, brother. Okay, provecho. Disfruta la comida, mi hermano. This CCNP book needs to be rewritten. Okay, they leave too much to the imagination. Echo, is that Echo? Peter, what's up, man? What's up? All right, and it leaves a lot to the imagination. You really, I mean, like I've said it before, I said it again. I've been dragging, crawling, pins and needles with this book. De nada, de nada. What's up, Ben? I missed the zone-based firewalls. No, well, that's on the, that's only, I'm only doing that for my CCMP students. CCMP students is basically, just give you an overview, is you put not every segment, but parts of your network in a particular zone, okay, a security zone, okay, and then you create access lists for these security zones, you put it into a class map, and you apply it through a policy. That's pretty much it. Hello, I'm Inyam from England. Hello, Rehan, am I pronouncing that correctly? I'm sorry if I'm not. Rehan, okay, hello, how are you? I was in England, I was in the UK, I think it was last year, the year before, and I loved it, okay, can't wait to go back. All right, but you need to have a good understanding of networking before you get into anything else, please. People that are getting into this security stuff, even Security Plus, that's not an entry-level position. I think in one of my lives with Adam, he said it, Security Plus is not an entry-level position. It is not. You need to have a good understanding of networking. Germany, guten Tag. Fräulein, Judy, I think I'm saying that correctly. I don't know. I like German language. I want to learn it. Okay. Definitely, you know, having a good foundation is crucial, whether it be your A plus, your network plus, security plus. Listen, right now I said that that's something that, you know, you should get. No, that's something you must get. Yes. Danke. That's what you need to make sure you get. Okay. You need to have Security Plus if you want to be employable. And let me tell you, 2000, where are we at? We're in 2020. I was going to say 2001. Wow. 2021. Thank you, sir. Thank you. 2021, there's going to be a blow up. Thank you, Ruo. I appreciate that, brother. I appreciate that. I appreciate all you guys. The IT is exploding. It's exploding. Okay. I get updates constantly, all right, from all over. And my own, I got my own paper. Oh my God, I can't believe I don't even know. It's Cisco Press. If my wife is listening, she can put the link to my newspaper. The Cisco, I think it's Cisco, oh my God, Cisco Press, something. I don't know. It's the Cisco Daily Planet. Oh, that's what it is. The Cisco Daily Planet, okay? The Cisco Daily Planet, and we get updates there among, you know, people sending me stuff, okay? And everywhere, Linux is taking over, definitely security is taking over, cloud's taking over. You need to know foundational networking. Oh my God, do you need to know foundational networking? You will not believe. And Amazon, cloud, all these different things, you need to know, at least know the basics of certain things. Like I said, Linux, Security Plus, Network Plus, CCNA, okay, and then you may want to get a cloud, let's say, that would be a cloud certification like Azure or AWS. Get one of those. Get these understandings. You have to do it. You have no choice but to do it so you can be employable. If you don't have these pieces of paper, like before, you needed your high school. And then from your high school, you needed your college. And then, you got your bachelor's, and then you had to go on to your master's. Now that don't mean squat. What are the most frequent problems for CCNA technicians in real life? Rodrigo. depending on how many years that CCNA has in that real life situational network that he's in, what does he do? There's some CCNAs that, listen, I worked in a telecommunications company. I have full-blown, administrative privileges to the router, and all I did was aggregate lines. I didn't configure one routing protocol, not one. I didn't do anything that the CIS put an IP address. You had spreadsheets, okay? IP address, that's it. So, and I can tell you that in real world and testing, what do they run into that they have major issues? That if they don't have a calculator next to them, they can't subnet to save their life. Okay, they can't. And you can say, what is it? That's a very generalized question, man. You can ask that. That's fine. But the whole thing is that everybody that gets hired, every network is completely different. So the different position that you're in, hey, Laz, when you have a chance to answer, is Herb doing the job search course interview course soon? He's pretty busy, bro, right now. He's juggling a million things to do that. But I think he gave you his contact information. So if you can go ahead and contact him, because remember, he works in DC government, okay? And he works at the NOC. So, you know, with all this stuff that's going on right now with the election and, you know, security and all these different things, there he's just been inundated with work. You know, you're talking about, you know, the instructors that are with me. These are people that, you know, Herb, 40 years, Jolie, over 20 years, like myself, Adam, that, you know, his courses are not going to come out till next year. South Africa, you know, just the time difference is incredible. And he himself is getting himself prepped and he wants to create a good course. So his course is not coming out till next year. Okay. I've been doing this already for 7 years. So it's easy for me to put out a course quickly. And normally it's going to be a Cisco course. I am going to do it. I don't know when. Thank you. Thank you, Judy. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. I really appreciate that. I'm glad. That makes me happy. Okay. I am going to put myself out there for Security Plus. All right. Because I am going to get the new 601. Whatever. Okay. I'm going to get it. Every year they update it. And I already looked at their domains. It's a pretty low score to pass. I think it's like a 720 or something like that. It's not bad. It looks like it's pretty simple. No big deal. I will reach out to him, connect with him on LinkedIn. Remember him saying that he was insane. He is. All of them are. These guys, you know, they're out there. So remember, this is what I do for a living now. Every so often, I'll get a contract. And right now, getting contracts, you know, with this insanity that's going on, it's not, you know, it's not easy. And to be honest with you, I don't want it. I'd rather just do this. That's why I have the Discord server now. Okay. I've been trying to invite people to the Discord server. As a matter of fact, can I get it all on here? Yeah, I think I can. Can I? I have a Discord server. Have you guys gone to a Discord server, sir? Yet? Discord.com. Let me see if I open. Okay. This is me. I never done this before. So there's like, oh, it's me. Okay, cool. Let me see if I can give you the link. Not friends. Hold on. Where I go into? Where the hell do I go into? I don't even know where I went to. Wow. Go here. Okay, cool. Invite people. All right. Copy. All right, I'm putting it here on the share. Okay. That's my Discord server. All right, so go ahead and. All right, go ahead and click on that link and you can get to me. And we already have a couple people on there. I don't know how many we have. I think we have like 20 people or something like that. All right, but go in there and let's start discussing different topics like zone-based firewalls, okay? Or whatever you want to get into. But definitely, I'll show it to you right now. There it is right there. Let me take that out your way. Hold on. Where is it? Oh, here it is. Hide it. Okay, there's my Discord server right there. Okay, so join. Hello, 128. All right, so definitely, you know, get in there. Hey, all right, our bros. Cool. People are joining. Awesome. Hello to everybody that's joining. Okay, so go on there, and then we can actually discuss back and forth topics that you guys want to go ahead and discuss. Okay, we have No Blinky Blink. All right, he's an instructor himself. He's been in IT for a whole bunch of years. I reached out to a lot of people on my Instagram. That was easy to do. And they've been in IT for years, so they're joining in. Adam is there. Herb is there. Jolie is there. Okay. Sunshine, a lot of my students are there. Okay. So definitely, you know, your input, your real world experience, share it with us and see what's going on. Because people tell me, hey, Laz, how can I fix this issue? This is what's going on over here. And they want to get an understanding of what's going on. And it could be as simple as, you know, subnetting. Okay, I know I say it like that because I've been doing it for so long, but it's something as simple as subnetting, it's something as simple as basic. And listen, in the CCMP chapter, what was that chapter? 25. It's towards the back. They're putting usernames. And there's an actual command is called algorithm type script. And you can pick 8 or 9, it'll like encrypt your passwords. This is huge. Okay, so. But that they're putting that in the CCMP, CCIE? Okay. All right, so whatever. That could have been something you could have taught them at Network Plus. I mean, seriously. So with me, I give every Network Plus and CCNA student, they're like, didn't we learn this in Network Plus? Yeah. Now I'm going to give you, reiterate it in the CCNA and then some, okay, and expand upon it. And when you get to, you know, the next level, definitely going to expand upon that. Because the more you do things, repetition breeds retention. I need you guys, even though the CCNA right now, Network Plus isn't, which is kind of interesting. The Network Plus, it's 90 minutes, 90 questions. They do have some simulations, okay? Multiple choice, you know, multiple response, all that stuff, drag and drop. But CCNA is just drag and drop, okay? CCNA is just drag and drop. CCNA is just drag and drop and multiple choice, multiple response, which is kind of sad because it makes the test not very climactic at the end after 2 hours of taking a test of 102 questions. And you pass, great, but it's not the same feeling as the feeling you get when you fix a network. You know, oh, it's broken. Now I fix it. It took me 3 hours, but guess what? It's not working. People are communicating. Awesome. That's a great feeling for me anyway. That's awesome. Even if it's on the simulator. What's wrong? And it was as simple as a typo because you put there. And you know how many typos I've made in labs, in real world, and especially in telecommunications where you're doing the same thing over and over again. So we just copy, paste, and I don't change the static IP address and I'm pointing it to the wrong place and the site doesn't come up. I'm like, why? Oh, I put the wrong IP address. And 9 out of 10 times, that's the reason. So that's what people are doing. So me, stop saying real world and stop being afraid of that word. You don't have no real world experience. Which real world? Which? Okay. And another question or something that actually came up during one of my boot camps was, Lance, who else is teaching online? Live online, not self-paced courses. Who else is teaching live online? Nobody. Not that I know of. As far as Tom Lanley, he does live seminars. He does them in Texas for his firepower, right? He does live seminars. And he does do live online boot camps, but not like me. He has a different method of doing his live online boot camps. Okay. But besides him and me, I don't see nobody else. Nobody else. Nobody else that you can reach out to and say, Laz, why is this? And you get an answer right then and there because you got me live, like right now. Okay. You got me live right now. All right. And these are the kind of things that I tell you because this is what I want to see in my boot camp. All right. I've been doing boot camps for a long time now. Boot camps, live online coaching, live online training, whatever you want to call it. I don't care. Okay. Point is, once you take one of my courses live online, that you got me present right there with you, now is the time for you to ask all the questions. Now is the time for you to be there. Okay. And when I tell you it's your turn, all right, to go ahead and configure, then you better configure. Don't give me an excuse, okay? If you're working, tell me, hey, Laz, I'm working wrong. I'm gonna listen, all right? And then I'll go over it again. Cool, not a big deal. If you're working, I understand, all right? But at least be there so you can hear me and you can hear the other students, okay, that are there asking questions and then you can, you know, you can get that tape. So do that, all right? But if you're paying for it, be there. Be there and ask questions, okay? That's what I want. I mean, I'm coming to you because I need you guys to be certified because I'm really not in fear, I'm concerned about next year. Everything is really up in the air next year. Is things being bought, you know, bought from different companies? Are data centers being created? Are all these things, you know, getting done? You know, and IT is now, you know, changed to cloud and telework and all this stuff. So they do need people that have networking fundamentals, people that know how to telnet. Okay, I have been in help desk positions, outsourced help desk positions, where IT people did not know how to download a driver back in the days of Windows 2000. Okay, that I had to walk them through downloading a driver. People that work in IT. Listen. Right now, I am amazed that I'm with you guys. I've been testing my internet speed. I have, you tell me, I have Cat 6 cable, gig NIC card. I have a all-in-one router from my provider. Should be gig ports. I'm pretty sure they're gig ports, okay? And sometimes I'm running a gig. That's internal. Sometimes I'm running 100 megs. How is that? I'm paying for 1 gig internet, $100 a month, 1 gig internet. What am I getting? I checked it last night. I was getting, I couldn't even connect to speedtest.net. I connected to some other, checked my speed, all right? And it was 5 megabits. Ridiculous. The day before in speedtest.net, I was able to connect. I had like 45 megabits. What's going on, people? It's the internet. The internet has exponentially grown again, okay? Because of this pandemic, all right? And yeah, take this pandemic seriously for your jobs. I mean, your health as well, obviously. Your health as well. Take proper precautions. I don't want anybody to get sick, okay? Take proper precautions. This is a flu. It's a little stronger flu. Flu nonetheless, okay? 99.9% survival, all right? That you're gonna come out of it, all right? So this fear-mongering needs to stop. But besides that, okay, because of that, IT has changed and they've created new topologies, Spider Leaf. They've created new protocols, VXLAN, Lisp, okay? So now, brand new this year, as of February 24th, okay, new ways of doing things, accessless that we didn't know till the CCNA 200-125 that existed, putting ports in the middle. Now, if you worked at a data center, you probably did. Why? Because these are access lists, were extended access lists, where you put not only source IP addresses, but source port numbers, EQ23 on the source, or this year has been busier than ever. World still needs its IT professionals, but yeah, you have to. What's up, Adam? Good to see you, bro. Dude, I got a question for you. I'm glad you're here. Sorry, I'm gonna hit you straight up. Zone-based firewalls. What is the craziness with this stuff? Good evening, sir. What is the craziness with this stuff? Okay, do we create the zone base? And I'm talking about in a Cisco router, in the CLI, creating the zone first, and then creating the access list, and then doing the class maps, and then employing the policy servers, and then applying it to the policy maps, and then applying it to the zone pairs with the service policy. That is the order. Yes? I know I threw a lot out you out there, but this the explanations that I got to go through with the CCNP is insane because they don't explain it. They just give you a bunch of access lists for you to just type in, which you don't have because you didn't create an ISACAMP policy, all right? And then they throw ports at you like you know what those ports are. Some of you may know what those ports are. I mean, there are 65,535 ports. Does everybody know what each port means? Has anybody memorized 65,535 ports? Nope. 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 All right. So they just throw these ports out there. You're like, what the hell is this? So guess where you go? Google. Google is the oracle. I'm telling you, I took the red pill. I am outside the matrix. I will never go back inside. I am free. Okay. I will never be back in the matrix. I am free. I am out here. I'm in the real world. I see everything. Okay. And when I go through books, I go through it with a fine-tooth comb. And not every book is the same. Not every book, there's no book error-free. That's number one. There's no book that's error-free. It's not. You know what I mean? I made tons of errors. All right. It gives you an option to have some. Here's Adam. Adam's and reply. It gives you an option to have some form of access control and inspection on a router if you're not able to use your firewall. Okay, cool. So then my student, Sunshine, was correct. She says, screw that. I'm going to keep my Fortinet firewall. I'll do everything through there. Okay. So, but for the test, you need to know that. They have labs in there for it. But labs that you need to have an instructor like me that's going to make sense of the lab and create these labs for you, and then we can go ahead and do these labs. As a matter of fact, people say that Packet Tracer is crap. Packet Tracer does zone-based firewalls. How about that? It does class maps. It does policy maps. How about that? okay? And so is GNS3. But guess what we found out on GNS3? And I think this is a quirk, okay? It's something funny. We changed the labels, We, you know, we said PC2, we have PC1, PC2, PC3. We changed the labels. We switched PC2 and PC3 around, just the labels. We just changed, we named PC2, PC3, and PC3, PC2, and they couldn't ping. So apparently that if you do that, that's changing the name of the computer. So now you change the how somehow. So it's like, really? Okay, interesting. So using simulators, every simulator has this quirks, has this little caveats, okay? And I can tell you that CML2, get ready. They better come up with a 1,000 page book to use CML2 properly, okay? And if we can please have, if anybody here works at Cisco, can you please tell them to send, to update their, or send us an update so we can do it, so we can have the proper IOSs to match the CCMP book, or so we can do VRP and all these things that they want like we should, all right? Because right now, yeah, right now it's GNS3, EVNG, that's the only two that I, or Packet Tracer, for that matter, that I tell people to use. Other than that, I wouldn't trust anything else, okay? But again, we go back, an organization that cannot afford a hardware firewall device uses alternative, i.e. implementing firewall features on a Cisco IOS router by using zone-based firewalls. Okay, all right, good enough for me. I mean, that's fine. So basically, we're not going to be using that in a real-world environment, because in a real-world environment, it's all about clicking, okay? So you will be clicking, according to Cisco anyway, in their book, even though they say that, even though Cisco at the beginning of their book says, this is not the opinion of Cisco, it is of the author. Really? I didn't know this was a novel, all right? I thought this was an IT book, a technical book. So apparently now we have to have our own interpretations. Don't you love that? Don't you remember when you were going to school? Yeah, you should rarely bump into that in the real world. Yeah, I mean, some people may need to be able to configure that. You'll need to know not even how to configure it, but at least understand the concepts of what a zone-based firewall that Adam is putting in right there. But the terminology, the definitions, how the order of applying things and creating access lists and doing all these different stuff. But as far as in a real-world scenario, yeah, hopefully you work for a real company that has real money and they're not cheap to use it. So you can have a real firewall and you won't have to worry about creating zone-based firewalls on your router, okay? Because I mean, they first talk about all this automated stuff like the umbrella, and they talk about the Cisco threat grid, and they talk about that web express mobility or web mobility express, something like that, with all this granularity because of the TLOS organization and all this, the information that they get, you can apply the concepts you learned from ZBF to a network firewall. So don't write it off. No, I'm not writing it off at all. We actually created the lab and we had to finish it in GNS3. And we actually saw some traffic. We saw when we looked at the policy, we actually saw things, that happened. So that was pretty cool that we did that. But we're going to do it again this weekend because we need to get it down packed. You know what I mean? What is the buzz? The buzz is that everybody needs to get certified. Everybody needs to put their skates on. Forget about Santa Claus, okay? Forget about Christmas. Not forget about it. Have your Christmas dinner. Have your Thanksgiving dinner. Or Hanukkah or whatever it is that you celebrate. Have your New Year's. Don't get drunk, okay? Because January 5th, I have a class. What class was that I said that I have? All right. January 5th, I have a class coming up. Let me get my schedule. What IT person? Oh, look at that. Look, it's like getting into the green screen. It's part of my living room. Awesome. Okay, where is this? January 5th. I know I said something. Yeah, January 5th is my Net Plus. I'm doing a Net Plus starting January 5th. So be sober by that time. Okay, be sober. And way we can go ahead and do what we need to do. Go back at it again. I'll share it again. All right. Go to globeed.net, please. Globeed.net. globeed.net. That way you can subscribe. I got a lot of things are upcoming. The biggest thing is that 95% off all self-paced courses. I'm making it possible for you guys to get this now. I know times are hard. I know this. I know this. But you got to get ready for the new year. I know you're saying the kids, the wife, the mother-in-law. You know, I think my wife needs a vacation from me. Okay. Since I've been working at home for 7 years, I don't leave her alone 24/7. You know what I mean? And my stepdaughter, she's probably sick of me. All right. So because they see me every minute of the day, they may want me to go do a contract for about a year or something to get rid of me. I don't know. But the point is that I know you want to be with your family. I know you want to do things. You know, do what you got to do that day, whatever. Couple hours, mingle, you know, hug, kiss the family, say what's up, you know, be safe when you're doing that. But your focus needs to be on your future. And we live right now in very uncertain times. We need to make sure that we get these certifications. The CompTIA certifications, the Linux Plus, Security Plus, Network Plus, CCNA, okay? Get a cloud-based certification, all right? Get into all it. What's up, Gate? What's up? You need to get these things going, okay? When Adam, because Adam is, you know, it's amazing that he's even here. That's why he said good evening. He's in South Africa, okay? Look it up. See what time it is over there. Okay, and he's on here. So Adam, thank you once again for showing up. Thank you so much. What's up, Jason? Herb is inundated, bro. I've been looking. I haven't seen anything, but I know that you got Herb's contact. Try to contact Herb. He's got all that work-related stuff going. That'll be your best bet, man, because he's the one that's knee-deep in that up in D.C. But, you know, from my understanding, you know, everybody everywhere is making changes in IT. Because everybody's network is failing, all right? Nico, hello, Lass, everyone. I can add after 4 certifications in 3 months of intensive studying, my fiance finding me on the kitchen table, sleeping on a book, going to bed at 4 a.m., I got a job offer. Congratulations, my friend. Congratulations. You deserve it. You deserve it. Good for you. You got it. Very good. Hey, Adam. Oh, hey, look, Mr. Rero is also in South Africa. There you go. You got a compatriot there with you. All right. Congratulations, Nico. I'm happy for you, brother. Happy for your family. Laz, what's up, bro? Jared, what's going on, yo? Okay. We need to get our future together. Okay. And listen, even me, who was the enemy of Linux, I hated Linux with a passion. Now I gotta embrace Linux. I have to get my Linux certification next year. I have to renew my Security Plus. All right. And other certifications that I need to renew. And I'm going to take them. Whatever. I have to. I have no choice. All right. Because I have to keep up to date with everything. And people are like, well, my age. And, you know, listen, it's not about your age. It don't mean nothing. You got this going good. You're okay. Don't worry about it. You don't got to be like me and, you know, deadlift 500, 600 pounds. I have 3 goals for 2021. Network Plus, Security Plus. And DEF CON, you're going to have to explain that one to me. DEF CON 29, Clarence. What's DEF CON 29? Is that a real certification or we're talking about the end of the world type of DEF CON? What is it? I don't know what that is. I really don't know. DEF CON. Elaborate on that. That would be interesting. I want to look into that. Okay. Now that I'm going to go deep into that security, CCNA security is as far as I went. I'm not taking CCNP security. I'll do the Security Plus next year. I am going to do it. I'm going to do it. I said it now live. All right. And I'm going to push myself. I'm going to go ahead and do the Security Plus 601. All right. What's up, Martin? DEF CON. Okay. Nick, I am a student of yours on Udemy and taking CompTIA Network Plus at the moment. Thanks for your teaching. Your guidance is fantastic. Thank you, Nick. Thank you. Network Plus has a little bit of changes. If you're my Udemy student, look for me. Okay, if you're here now, you see that picture of me with a Panama hat. You know, you see me that if you see that Panama hat picture, hook up with me on LinkedIn, okay, or hook up with me with that Panama hat. That's what I have on my phone. Or look for me in Networking Doctors Instagram. That way, I can respond to you quicker. Responding to you through Udemy. It's painstaking, okay? It's and I've been horrible at answering, I'll be honest. And I'm going to change that. That's one of my New Year's resolution, is to change that. To start answering more on every other platform. I belong to 40 platforms, guys. 40 plus on platforms. On Udemy alone, I have hundreds of thousands of students. So it's hard to keep track. But if you reach out to me, it's right on my phone. Okay, it's right on my phone. If you reach out to me on Instagram, I can message you right back. You know what I'm saying? Or LinkedIn, I can hit you up real quick. Okay, but to go log in, because my application for that particular platform, it's not working. It never worked right to begin with. Okay, so I have issues. But that's why I do live online bootcamps. And right now, like I said, whatever you can call it, whatever you want, I'm doing it for your own benefit. Okay. Nico, okay, we'll do. Awesome, Nick. Awesome. Awesome. Okay. I'm doing that 95% off all self-paid courses. Don't be slick. Okay. Don't be slick, because you can get refunded. Okay. Self-paced courses. Take them now. 95% off. Come on. Come on. All right. I need you guys to get certified. Laz, you know where I can get questions to go along with Jolie's course? That I don't know, bro. The Linux? I have no freaking clue, bro. Unless you do, let me ask Jolie. Let me text Jolie after I'm done with this live. I'll text Jolie, and I got your number, so I'll text you back, okay? So definitely, Jolie would know. Probably, no. Do you have any Linux? You took his Linux 101? Yeah, Linux Plus. Yeah, Linux Plus. Go. The Linux Plus course is, if you have a Linux Plus book, but as far as actual other type of questions, can you register? Yeah, you should be able to register those Linux books online. I'm sure they have additional questions there. All right. So you can probably do that. Okay. You know where you can get other questions. All right. You're taking the course now. Okay. All right. Well, you know where you can get additional questions. You know this, all right? With an AWS course. Awesome. Awesome. That's the way to go, man. There you go. Jason is a prime example of a person who's taking charge and says, I'm going to get my shit together. Well, he's already had his shit together. But he's going to get tight. He's going to tighten up. Forget about life for a while. Dig in. And friggin' by next year, he's going to come out the other side smelling like roses, okay? And he's going to be up there. He's going to be one of those ones that's going to be in charge, okay? So that's what you guys need to do as well, ladies and gentlemen. I don't know when I'm putting this out, okay? I don't know when, but it's coming out next year. And it's a busy year. It's been a busy year this year. It's going to be even a busier year next year with, I'm doing CCNP again. I'm doing Network Plus. I'm doing CCNA. I'm doing all these classes. I'm going to do the Security Plus. These are boot camps, or I call them boot camps. New terminology, live online coaching, okay? That I'm going to be doing with you guys, but I am going to put out a course so you can learn to do what I do. I'm not telling you you need to get in front of a camera. Okay. You don't need to. I know everybody's shy. Okay. Listen, I don't have a problem getting in front of a camera. Okay. But I got a problem getting in front of the phone. When I get in front of the phone, I go all live on Instagram. It feels weird to me, but I can get in front of any camera, TV camera, the camera that I do my courses on, this webcam. I don't have an issue. Right. But some people do, but you don't have to, right? You can put yourself in the lower left-hand corner or something if you want, or as long as you have your voice, that's fine. Nobody needs to look at your facial expressions, okay? And you can do what I'm doing. Now, if you're going to do live on YouTube, be live, okay? People want to see you, okay? But if you do what I do, you'll be taking the red pill, you'll be setting yourself free, you'll be leaving the matrix, and there's no turning back. FYI for everyone, what's that? What's that, Jason? FYI. I'm giving an FYI. Oh, Test Out is having a Black Friday sale. Cool. All right. There you go. All right. Thank you, Jason. Thank you for that information, sir. I appreciate that. All right. Take advantage of all the sales. Take advantage of all sales because you need to get ready. You need to get ready. I'm telling you, 2021 is going to be a very interesting year. Very interesting year. But I see things. I see things, and I do get certain emails that I look at and I see, because the emails is usually my wife that handles. I handle the technical side of it, but I'm kind of whatever to get inside the emails. But again, that's why I tell you to go to IG, go to Instagram, go to LinkedIn, so you can get a hold of me quicker. And there's certain questions that I just don't get. People that are still in the field that are, you know, my IP book has been out there for I don't know how long now. My IPv4 course, that's why I'm doing a live online IPv4 course. A live online IPv4 course, okay? So, because it's not because, well, Laz is just doing that because that's really what he knows. No, it's a fact that a lot of people are struggling out there because of that. When I looked at what's in the CCNP, I said, why are they giving you this definition in chapter 30 and this should have been given to you in chapter 10? Okay. And I see configurations that are like, well, this is just, why is it even here? It doesn't even make sense. A lot of the things that's going on, but that's why you need to get the foundational stuff, get the foundational stuff and go through it with a fine tooth comb and question everything. Why are you calling? Listen, the only reason I knew what ephemeral was, I'm like, what the hell's an ephemeral port? Okay. It's because I watched Penny Dreadful. And then I looked it up online. And it said, oh, it's something that is short lasting. Oh, okay. And I know what ephemeral means. Spurious. What the hell? Why can't you just call it rogue? You know, it's just, you know, I nitpick, okay? But it's like you're making it confusing for the students. If you're going to make a change, make a real change. That's going to, like, say, okay, now we're going to configure the routing protocols under the interface only. Now we're not going to do, when we do spanning tree, even though they teach you spanning tree in Network Plus, by the way, okay, and in the CCNA, but they want to get rid of it in the real world, okay? In the spanning tree, they want you to create now, you've always been able to create a root bridge by saying root primary or root secondary. And whoever, and there was a, I'm humbled by how you do so many. Martin, if you would have met, I'm sorry, I know I'm cutting off, but I just got to address that question. Martin, if you would have met me while I was going through school, you would have thought I was an idiot because I couldn't subnet to save my life. Why? Because they were teaching me that 2 to the n minus this and ending and high order bits and lower order bits until finally a light bulb turned on. It was an actual guy who was an instructor. He went to Cisco. He more or less gave me this idea, and then I just ran with it, okay? I'm like, okay. And then I took it and I applied it to IPv6 and it works. It works. Okay. And in my Networks Plus class, I show you a little trick with IPv6. Okay. That I don't have in my book, actually, in my Networks Plus class. But I'm going to do a YouTube video about it and put it out there if I haven't done already. I don't remember. I don't remember nothing I do sometimes now because I'm working every single freaking day. Okay. At 5 today. Yeah. 5 to 9. I got a boot camp today, 5 to 9, but I had to come out and give you guys a shout out. All right. But thank you, Martin. I appreciate that. And I want everybody to be able to subnet, to do route summarization, to be able to look at IP address and say, boom, this is what it is. Reading the only IP book yourself, you explain subnetting brilliantly. Thank you, Nick. I appreciate that. I appreciate that. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. The only reason I kind of stopped on that because somebody gave me a definition for guru. It means something, but thank you. Thank you. I try my best. And I know that's the kryptonite of every IT individual out there. And that's why I did all these videos on IT. And now I'm actually doing a live online course. So if you really want to, you have the book, you have the course. If you want to get the author, the instructor of IP live online, well, now's your chance. Okay. Go to GlobeEd. And take a look at it. Let me look at it. I'm right here right now. When is it? When is it? When am I having this course? Well, I have a course out, but I have it's a live online IP course. I don't know. I think they have to create it. They haven't created it yet. The only IPv course, Oh yeah, the coaching class. Here it is. The only IPv4. Here, let me share it. It's right there at the very beginning. The only IPv4 coaching class you will ever need, December 1st, 2020. Well, that date changed, I think. No, I think, did it change? I don't know if they've updated it because I think that was, just check on it, okay? But I'll let you know if anything. That's why you guys need to subscribe to the site to make changes, you get the updates. Let's see where it's at here. Yeah, no, it is December 1st. It is December 1st. It is December 1st. Okay, so it's December 1st. Okay, so it's gonna be me. It's gonna be me. Okay, so it'll be live online. That's what I mean. It's gonna be live online. All right, so why don't just finally get it over with and know it once and for all? Because like I told my student, what's the book called? The only IP book you will ever need. And that's on Amazon. And I have it right here. Let me share it with you. There it is on Amazon. I got a searches in Amazon. It's IPv4, IPv6 subnetting. Two books come up. I'm one of them. And here it is right here. Okay. And then email me the receipt and I'll send you the PDF for free. Okay. But if you want to take the course, take it with me, and then you ask all the questions, because I just don't want to go blah, 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 blah. I want to know where you're having issues. Because one of the things is, when we do IP addressing, it's very straightforward. But like I went through access list last night, we went through some access list questions. You're welcome, brother. You're welcome. I went through some access list questions, 20 questions, right? But some of the questions in the access list had nothing to do with access list. It was subnetting. Because access list, as you know, we use wildcard masking. So that's part of IPv4. You'll be learning that as well. And you don't got to do all that crazy stuff that they make you do, this ending, whatever that means, okay? No, you don't have to do that. If you do what I tell you to do, if you listen to me, okay, I'm not here to mess you up. I'm here to move you forward. I am here to help you, guide you, put you where you need to be, okay? If you do, and look, who was that? Was that Nick? It was Nick, right? Who was it that, who was it? Who was it that got that job? Hello, Lazarus. Oh, yeah. Nico. That was Nico. Okay. Nico, after burning the midnight oil, being passed out on the kitchen table, okay, studying his butt off, he finally has, and 4 certifications, he finally has a job offer. He didn't quit. He pushed through. You can't quit. It's like, I forgot what this guy's name is. He's a motivator on YouTube. He's the one that says, how bad you want it, okay? If you, you know, as bad as you want to breathe, right? If you want it as bad as you want to breathe, then you want it bad enough, right? So this is the guy that says how bad you want it. This is not coming from me, okay? Another thing that he says is, why are you going to quit if you're already in pain? Go past it and then get something out of it. I mean, I put myself in a position. I always put myself in a position where I'm not comfortable, okay? I put myself in a position where it's like, I got to get this done. I must teach 3 times a day. I must be live almost every day. I have to do it, you know? And believe me, sometimes it's like, I'm like freaking dying, you know? I'm freaking dying, okay? And it's just, and I had an emergency one weekend that I couldn't teach that weekend CCMP. I had to go down south, okay? So it's like, I had an issue, all right? And the internet's been acting up. It's lucky that this thing hasn't cut off, okay? But you got to deal with all these bumps in the road. You have to deal with it. You just got to grind it out, because I'm telling you right now, 2021 is going to be full of surprises, all right? And I don't want you to be caught with your pants down. Get your certs. Get them now, okay? I don't care what it is. If it's a network plus and a security plus, okay? And then you start working from there. Linux plus, CCNA, get them now. And I know financially it's difficult. Listen, Santa couldn't bring all the toys you wanted. He was too busy, right? So here's this, you know, whatever. Quality is better than quantity, okay? And that also goes for certs, okay? When you get your cert, it's not about getting 50 or 100 certifications. You're going to get specific certifications and what you need to do, but we need a foundation. Just like we need to learn how to add, subtract, multiply, and divide, okay? You need to know, PS5. okay, well, did you hear that, Microsoft? They got, what is that? It's called, I didn't know this even existed, ROM hacking. They already hacked the new stuff from Microsoft or some games or something or another for PS5 or something. But anyway, you need your foundations, okay? You need to get those out of the way. But if anything, Network Plus, Security Plus, those two. Then get your CCNA. All right, but Security Plus is a must. Network Plus is a must. That's a must. Okay. And then you can worry about Linux. What did I say? Linux Plus, Security Plus. No. What did I say? I said Network Plus and Security Plus. Then get Linux if you can after that. All right. And was it four? I don't remember anymore. I've been saying it so many times. You got what? Your Network Plus, Security Plus, Linux Plus, and there's one more. Where am I leaving out? Okay. I don't know. Well, the Security Plus was 8 Plus. That's all that stuff, right? But importantly, Linux Plus, Security Plus, and Network Plus. All right. And then go for your CCNA. All right. I don't know if there's any Microsoft fans out there. I remember when I failed my CCNA orientation, I booked it again. I had 2 days to prepare. I wrote it and I passed it. Second sleeping, that's fine, dude. But then you got it. You took it twice, right? Cool. You passed it. Now you know even more. Okay. A Plus, Network Plus, Security Plus. Awesome, Jason. Awesome. Keep it up, brother. Keep going, dude. Keep going forward. Do what you need to do. Do what you need to do and get those certs, okay? You have the real world experience. You've been out there in IT companies. You know you've been doing the work, okay? So it's not like you've never touched a piece of equipment, okay? Also, your CCNA. Beautiful. Do that. All right, get all these things under your belt. I need you guys to really be ready, okay? I'm not gonna bore you any longer. I just wanna remember, I wanna remind you, please, pretty please, okay? Go to globed.net. There's these courses that are coming up. Scroll through it. No, not there, here. Scroll through it, okay? I got Networks Plus coming up. The course is there. All the courses are 95% off. Not all the courses, the self-paced courses, okay? But take a look at it. There's your Ansible. Okay, go through globed.net. Here's the book and Amazon. All right, and here is my Discord server. Okay, I'm gonna put the share in there again. I'm gonna invite people just in case for people that just came in and maybe didn't see it. There's my Discord server. Okay, all right, for you guys to join. So what you wanna see, you let me know. Okay, we can have discussions on the Discord server on anything. And I'm waiting for Adam. When he's available to help me out to get this thing in order. So I have no idea what I'm doing in there. Okay. I've had this thing for 2 years. I didn't even know. Okay. So, but now I got it and I want to make sure that I use it. That way it's another way we can reach each other. And that way we can start doing things. We can start sharing experiences, sharing knowledge. Lads, I just want to understand when you become a CCNA, do you become a network administrator or a network engineer? Neither, either, or who knows, okay? I had all my certs, CCMP. All right. Laz, if you need admins for the Discord, let me know. Okay, well, I know Adam is one admin. I don't know how I did it, but I gave him just full access. I don't know, to do whatever he needs to do in there. All right, but I'll let you know, most definitely. Who said that question? Damn it. Martin. CCNA just gives you a certification, brother. It gets your foot in the door. It doesn't make you anything. Okay? It doesn't give you... When I got into telecommunications, okay, I had my CCMP already. All right? I think I had my... Part of my CCIE. I had my written CCIE. Okay? And I had all my other crap. Okay? But with them, okay, with them... with them, I was just another switch engineer, okay, which I didn't know anything about the switch. They taught me at that point, all right, but I had administrative privileges to it, but I didn't have a title as far. My title was switch engineer, period. I wasn't an administrator or anything like that, okay? So it all depends whatever you're going to do for that particular company. What's up, bro? I got you on here. Psy3, what is it? What is this? Psy3 Tech? Psy, I don't know what that means. Cyber tech, maybe. Okay. Lord of the Rings is typing. Okay. Old time student. Okay. What's up? All right. But it doesn't give you a title, man. It all depends what they make you do there. Danny, hi, Laz. How did networking CCNA change your life? You need some motivation, bro? It all depends how you got your CCNA, my friend. If you did the hard work, if you did the reading, if you did the labbing, whether it's simulator or live equipment. Yeah, it did open a lot of doors for me. especially in the educational side, because that's where I chose that route, where doors open wide, contracts open wide, because companies wanted me. Oh, he's a CCNA. Let's get him in here to teach us routing protocol, because we don't know. So it did open doors for me. It did. When I had just my Microsoft, listen, University of Miami, I was a Microsoft Office specialist, okay? I had my MCSE, I had my Network Plus, my A Plus, didn't have my Cisco, and I passed their test with flying colors, okay? Their typing test and everything. You know what they told me, Danny? You know what they told me? Man, if you only, I was applying for a networking job. You know what they told me? They said, well, if you only had a CCNA. I'm like, you bastards. You know what I mean? It's like, really? Really? And I had a particular student, not to talk bad of students, but this one student was, no. It was when I was in the brick and mortar. This particular student came in late, left early. He wanted to fight me outside, okay, because I failed him, okay? And this is why I'm telling you, be weary of the educational institution you go to, okay? So this guy wanted to fight me. That was funny as hell. I went outside. They told me, Nas, don't go. I'm not going to do anything. I went outside. I had another student who said, told the guy not to do that. This guy was a Florida State champion martial artist. And the guy said, I'll fight both of you. And I'm like, okay, now I know he's crazy. So we went outside and nothing ever happened. He just jumped around like a monkey, right? He didn't know anything in routing, nothing at all. They told me, can you please put some magic dust on pixie dust, whatever it is, on his grades because his mommy and daddy are coming down to watch him graduate. So administration forced me to change the grade, okay? And he graduated, and guess what? He got a job at UM. You know why he got a job at UM in the networking department? Because his auntie worked there. And then he saw me a couple months later. He tried to rub it in my face. He goes, hey, Laz, guess what? I'm working at UM in networking. I go, you're not touching any routers, are you? Try to be slick in front of his friends. I go, you're not touching any routers, are you? And I said, no. Oh, thank God. Good. So, yeah, I'm Mr. Nice Guy. I'm here to help you. But do not cross the line with me. Especially, how in the world are you going to ask an instructor? You need to respect your instructor. He needs to respect you. But in turn, you need to respect them. They're giving you the knowledge that you need. If they're not, walk out of the damn classroom quietly, get your money refunded, and do what you need to do, okay? But this happened at a career college, okay? And I can tell you a million stories like that, okay, at this particular career college, all right, where I wasn't allowed to fail students. And give a student a D? Huh, it's unheard of. When we got it's an inspection they do every year for your accreditation. These other instructors from most schools come in there and they inspect, they cross, dot the I's and cross the T's, all right? And they said, ooh, this is very interesting that this school only has A's or F's. There is no curve, there's no bell. It's A or F, okay? It was ridiculous. So motivation, do the work. Will CCNA open the doors? Most definitely it will open doors for everything. The market in Miami sucks. That's why I'm in Orlando. Okay. I left Miami never to return. Okay. Never to return. Orlando or hell, Texas. That's where the hub is for everything. Okay. I'll never to return. There no way. And in Orlando, Miami is expensive as hell. All right. Orlando, man, the world is, and yeah, it's great up here. I love it. Okay. And if this keeps getting crap, yeah, I'm going somewhere else. All right. I don't care. Okay. Because I've already been in Europe all over. All right. So I know how much they pay, where to live, stuff like that. And I already have two contracts overseas anyway with Queen Mary University and the CC Muck. Those of you that are from Europe, you should know who these people are. Okay. Washington, D.C. I wouldn't set foot in Washington, D.C. because you better be getting paid 200 grand a year if you want to live in Washington, D.C., or you're not going to make it. And California California's turned into a cesspool. Not much less that California is too expensive to live in. Okay. Lots of government. Bro, there's government jobs everywhere. And there's military contracts everywhere. Look for military contract websites and you'll find them. That's how I found when I was in the technical institution a military government contract, I just, my wife, they let me go to Kuwait, or else I would have been in Kuwait for a year making 160 grand, 90 or 95% of that money would have been mine. Okay. So you don't need to be in DC to get a government job. Okay. You don't need to do that. DC is way too expensive. New York is hell. Everybody's leaving New York. You got what, over 300,000 people that have left New York. All right. Aren't you in New York, Jason? Aren't you in New York? Okay. How you think about Linux? No, Linux, there's no choice. You better get it. Cause even Cisco Simulator, their desktops are all Linux. They're Alpine Linux. Paul de Guzman, hi lads. I'm currently working in a NOC department. Just started handling layer two VPN issues on routers, but layer two VPN is making me nuts as I'm only a CCNA. Any books that you could recommend to master layer two? I don't know about mastering layer two VPNs, but in your CCNA, they should have mentioned layer two VPNs. Definitely the CCNP. And if you're going to get any books, I don't recommend. I recommend Cybex books or O'Reilly books. Those blue books that have like different animal shapes in the front of it. Get those books. Those are really good books. And they'll do a very good job on explaining that. But I think I even have a video on my YouTube on layer two VPNs. But reach out to me on the Discord. Okay. The somewhere in the chat is the share for that. Or reach out to me in Instagram, Networking Doctors Instagram, or my LinkedIn with that Panama hat, and we'll talk. I want to be in an area where I don't have to wear a bulletproof vest. Well, then you don't want to be in New York. You don't want to be in California. You don't want to be in Portland. You don't want to be in Washington, D.C., or Washington State, for that matter. Okay. So who knows, you know, what's going to happen. Here in Florida, we don't play that game. Okay. Here in Florida, we don't play those games. And I'm not trying to get political. I don't want to do that. We're talking about IT. Orlando is full of IT, IT jobs. Okay. That you can get here. Don't come to Minneapolis. Nope. Not happening anytime soon. Okay. But you listen, you need to follow the money, guys and gals. You need to follow the money. And you need to think of your future for your family or for yourself if you're not married or have a significant other or whatever the case may be. You need to follow where the money goes. You need to make your money stretch. I've told, we've been looking at this before none of this stupidity was happening. There's look online for expat communities, okay? And you will see many different people that, you know, they have either dual citizenships or they're still, Laz, any sites for government jobs? Let me find them. I know I do have some. I know for a fact I do have some, and I'll send them to you. Zebby, what's up? Okay. Scotland, Ireland, UK, okay. Many places in there you can work. Portugal, okay. Telecommunications companies there, all right. Anywhere, well, Germany wasn't, whatever. I really didn't look into much in Germany where I was there. But there's so many places over there that your U.S. dollar goes a long way. Okay, Portugal is one of those places. Okay, so you got to think outside the box. You can't just say, well, I'm just going to go to the next state and the next state and the next state and the next state and the next state. You don't know what can happen. You need to live globally. Okay, and think, okay, where is my money going to reach out to get me different, you know, make more for me? Make your money make more for you. Go longer, okay? Because if you get paid $80,000 in Florida, you're living a good lifestyle. You get paid $80,000 in Washington or California, you're starving. So think about the cost of living. And I'm going to type this in the chat, and this is what my wife always tells me to go to. Numbeo.com. Go there and research the cost of living one state to the next, one country to the next, and see, you know, where will be the best places and apply at those places. Okay. And what last I enrolled in your Network Plus in the first couple of days, and you announced it. It just want to ask. Okay, cool. I just want to ask when you believe you will finish the course. Dude, I'm trying to finish it before 2021. I did two videos today. that they're editing. I'm going to do some more. Since I'm doing boot camps every single day, it's kind of hard to film. These boot camps are over this week and next week, so I'll be able to film more and try to get that done. I should have it over before 2021, bro. In December, I should have that done. In December, there's no excuse. I should have the Network Plus done way before December, but if not, because we're already halfway through November, December definitely. What's this? What do you mean there are none? There are none what? You have to pay for it. You have to pay for what? What are you talking about? Are you talking to me? Oh, how I get free certificate? Oh, no. Yeah, okay. Never mind. Never mind. No, there are no free certificates, man. There's no... You want certificate? No, there's no free certificates. There are no free certificates. But anyway, I've already taken up a lot of your time. Reach me through here, because I always look at the comments in the morning. I look for comments on the YouTube videos, okay? I look at my LinkedIn. I looked at my Instagram, Networking Doctors, and the Discord server. So get a hold of me. Do you need a college degree to get a job in networking? If you go to a stupid company, yes. Most companies are asking for this. You need to make a good argument, Danny. You need to make a good argument. Okay, because I've gotten jobs. I only have a bachelor's. And I don't want a master's or a PhD or none of that crap. Okay. And when they ask you, you know, they shouldn't be, you know, yes, unfortunately, that has changed. That has changed. Trust me. All right. Look for companies. And I've seen companies in Orlando that don't ask for bachelor's, don't ask for any degree. They want certs. They want certs. So try to guide your search into companies like that, because I have taught not to downgrade any degree. Okay. I'm all about knowledge, but I have taught people that have come out of UM that have gone to my technical school, not my technical school, the technical school I worked at. Okay. I have taught people that come out of FIU that with networking degrees, programming degrees, whatever the hell they thought they needed, computer science degrees, that can't configure crap because they never did. So it doesn't, to me, I don't care if you got a bachelor. I've taught PhDs, the CCNA. They're chairpersons of their department, and they came to me, they found me somehow, and I taught them. And I don't blame them, okay? Because those degrees don't mean crap when it comes to a certification. Completely something different. And you have to make a good argument for that. I have a master's and my certs hold more weight. Jason, well, you're an intelligent man, brother. You're sure, and you better get those certs to pay off that freaking debt. All right. So just make a good argument, Danny. When you go there, one of the things you need to have, I don't know how you say it in English, in Spanish, muela, know how to BS your way through it or embellish your way through it. Show what you do know. Play your strengths, and that's it. Sir, please. Cloud. Okay, let's see what we can do with Cloud. Let's see who I can get for Cloud. All right, and let's make it in the Discord. Okay, let's make it in the Discord. Philip, top PhDs at senior DoD engineer, CompTIA A+ because it is required by the U.S. There you go. PhDs don't know shit about building a computer. Okay. No loans. You're the man. Damn, you're rich. Okay. That's awesome. All right. But anyway, I'm gonna let you guys go. Stay in contact with me. You know how to reach me. I put the Discord server on there. People have joined. You got my LinkedIn, and you got my Instagram, and you have my info at the Networking Doctor's email. Please comment on this. Comment on this. What you want to see? I have that thing for voting every Monday. So please do so. Okay. I started from nothing. I'm following the CompTIA pathway. I got ITF Plus at A+. Now working on cybersecurity. All right. Perfect. Do eventually cybersecurity. Do what you need to do. Way to go, Nick. You're welcome, Anthony. Always good to see all of you here. You guys stay safe. Take care. Keep driving. We're getting to December. January is right around the corner. Let's do what we need to do and get it done. Oh, you got the GI Bill. Okay. Yeah, I turned that down. I'm so smart. I'm going to be in the military for life. Not happen. Didn't happen. All right. But take care. Do what you need to do. That's all I got to say. Do what you need to do. All right. All right. You're welcome, everybody. I'll see you guys next time. Who knows when that will be. So subscribe to the YouTube channel.